Willkommen bei Plus Minus. Ich bin gestern Morgen von Hamburg nach Köln geflogen und ich bin gut angekommen, wie Sie sehen können. Offenbar allerdings keine Selbstverständlichkeit. Der Pilot hätte ja aus Übermüdung einschlafen und mit uns abstürzen können. Völliger Unsinn, sagen Sie jetzt vielleicht. Ist aber leider kein Unsinn. 70% aller Piloten sagen, dass sie im Cockpit schon einmal eingeschlafen sind, wegen totaler Erschöpfung. Aber wenn es nach dem Willen der EU-Kommission in Brüssel geht, sollen Piloten künftig noch länger arbeiten. Dabei brauchen wir nur auf die Straße zu schauen, um zu begreifen, wie gefährlich sowas ist.
Pictures from a surveillance camera. The frequent cause of accidents like this: fatigued drivers experiencing involuntary microsleep. Because of this, duty and rest times are checked by the police all over Europe, like here last week on the A2 at Dortmund. Since 2006, the basis for such stringent controls is an EU regulation. It has harmonized the different regulations all over Europe and is intended to improve road safety and to protect the drivers from becoming fatigued. Everybody knows that the longer you work, the more fatigued you become. Therefore, the regulator says, when you work longer, your rest time should also be increased. If rest is reduced, it will lead to falling asleep at the wheel. For trucks and buses, the rule is 4.5 hours driving, 45 minutes rest, 4.5 hours driving. After 9 hours, the day is over. The mandatory rest time between shifts is 11 hours, and this is regularly checked. European aviation is entirely different. On short and medium-haul flights, 13 hours duty time is legal. Twice a week, this can be extended up to 14 hours. This can even be further extended up to 15 hours with captain's discretion. To compare, the duty time for truck drivers ends after 9 hours. Experts criticize that longer working hours for pilots lead to a sleep deficit. This is verified by an Air Berlin captain who wants to remain anonymous. He says, "We have sleep deficit the entire summer period. Frequently the rest periods are too short or they don't match our normal sleep rhythm. So I'm in a sleep deficit the whole summer." This can have dramatic consequences. Accident investigation reports often show that fatigue is a major factor. For example, Guam, 1997, 228 fatalities. Little Rock, United States, 1999, 11 dead, 110 injuries. Zurich, 2001, 24 dead, 9 injuries. Buffalo, United States, 2009, 51 fatalities. And recently, Mangalore, India, summer 2010, 158 people perished. A study conducted by the US Federal Aviation Administration showed that pilots who were on duty for more than 12 hours were more likely to be involved in an accident. Remember, currently in Europe, 15 hours is legal. America has taken action. Tighter flight duty regulations will come into force in August. Europe has also taken action, but completely different. The European Aviation Safety Agency is the regulator. In order to achieve consistency across Europe, duty time regulations should be relaxed. A proposal was set out in December. Since then, there has been huge criticism from the pilot community. If these rules are implemented in the way they are currently being proposed, we fear a big backward step for flight safety. It has been scientifically established what humans are capable of, and these rules contradict all of it. If the planned limitations are put into force, it will cause fatigue and that will lead to accidents. In an EASA commissioned study, 10 highly renowned scientists came to a complete different conclusion than the agency itself. EASA is planning a daytime duty limit of 16 hours, but the experts caution the maximum should be 13 hours. The EU currently allows 11 hours 45 minutes at nighttime. According to the study, 10 hours should not be exceeded. But EASA is increasing this even more to 12 hours. Up to now, there has been no limit in the United States of America. Now, duty at night will be limited to just 9 hours. Can European pilots perform better than their US colleagues at night? Apparently, yes, as EASA even intends to allow a reduced rest time of just 7.5 hours twice a week. For Martin Wey-Voda, flight physiologist at the DLR in Cologne, this is incomprehensible. Since 1981, he has studied the effects of duty times on flight crews. Wey-Voda was one of the experts of the Möbus report.
He says,
I have to say, this is ridiculous. Whoever came up with this has never done regular duty over several months. Otherwise, they would have realized that 7.5 hours is out of question. Reasonable, sufficient sleep is the basic requirement for human performance. The EASA proposal is now in its final deliberation. It will then be presented to the Commission. EASA is already assessing the proposal as a success.
The proposal is balanced in terms of safety improvement as regards its potential consequences in terms of economics and social impact. This is what we are looking for when we develop a rulemaking proposal.
The bus drivers being checked here by the police do not agree. A pilot has 100, 200, 300 people in his plane, and he could crash into a city of 200,000 people.
Leute leben 13 hours
full concentration for me as a bus driver, this is already too long. And at the end of such a long duty is the most demanding part for every pilot, a safe landing. After such a long duty, you're aware that you're no longer functioning at 100%. Personally, I'm happy if I just get the plane somehow onto the ground. And in the future, probably after an even longer duty day and even less sleep. 30, 20, retard, retard.